So what is CTE? CTE, also known as chronic traumatic encephalopathy, is a progressive neurodegeneration disease. That means it's a slow brain disease. It was first described in 1928 when Dr. Harrison Martland described a group of boxers as having punch drunk syndrome. Over the next 75 years, several researchers reported similar findings in boxers and other victims of brain trauma. The most common neurodegeneration that we know about is Alzheimer's disease, and CTE is similar, but it's triggered by repetitive head trauma. And scientists found that after sufficient amounts of head trauma, this disease starts to develop in your brain and then becomes a progressive, widespread brain disease as time goes on. In this video, I'm going to talk about CTE, what it is, and steps you can do if you're worried that you might be suffering from it. My name is Sarah Jeffries. I'm a registered nurse with a Master's of Science in Nursing and experience in ER nursing and education. So CTE, in the simplest terms, is a brain disease, and it's a slow process of neurodegeneration. The devastating thing about this disease is that you can't make a diagnosis without a neuropathological examination of the brain tissue, and this is basically a brain biopsy, which can't be done on a living person. What doctors look at under the microscope of the brain tissue is the presence of the abnormal tau protein that clusters around blood vessels in the brain, and that's very distinct to CTE. There's no other disease that causes those changes in tau protein, and that's how doctors make the distinctive diagnosis. The symptoms of CTE also vary widely from person to person. The person can experience shifts and behavioral changes. There may be mood changes like depression. There are also things like aggression and violent behaviors, impulsivity, and also short fuses. Another common set of symptoms is memory loss, difficulty planning and organizing, and also difficulty with your attention span. What doctors see when they examine the brain of someone with a potential diagnosis of CTE are very tiny lesions in the cortex of the brain or in the gray matter of the brain. In the beginning of the disease, these lesions haven't spread to other parts of the brain. They're just isolated, and that's how it starts out. It spreads to other parts of the brain, and it also spreads to the deep nuclei of the brain, the brainstem, and it can even spread to the spinal cord. Eventually, CTE becomes a devastating disorder with lots of tau protein in so many regions of the brain. CTE symptoms can look different in each person, like I said earlier, and some people will be impulsive and violent. Other people will feel a mental fogginess and lack of clarity and feel like they've lost control over their brain or their thinking, and it varies for each person. Researchers aren't exactly sure why those differences occur, but they think it has to do with the location of the lesions. And that would make sense, because if one person has changes in the frontal cortex and another person has changes in the temporal lobe, these different parts of the brain are very different in what they do. For example, the temporal lobes control aggression and impulsivity, and the frontal lobe affects judgment and decision making. And the combination of the pathology of where it is in the brain determines what symptoms you might be suffering from. One thing researchers know is that an overload of subconcussive hits is linked to degenerative brain disease, and people with CTE suffer from changes in their mood and behavior as early as in their 30s and their 40s. There is much more awareness among fans and athletes, including the NFL, boxing and MMA, but not nearly enough, and so much more needs to be done. And it starts with your education, educating yourself on how to protect your brain. You only get one brain. Once you do the damage, there's very little you can do to reverse it. There are things, but it's very limited. My husband Tony is an undefeated Olympic bronze medalist and is on a similar journey, and he's going to be releasing a video about this in the future, documenting all of this. The first step that he took was to cut out all alcohol. He doesn't do any drugs, but if he did, he also would have stopped this. We really got serious about this, wanted to bring more awareness to everybody, and we read a great book, and everybody should read this. It's called Damage by Tris Dixon. And in this book, he interviews so many boxers and boxers' widows. But in particular, one person stuck out in my mind was George Foreman. Mr. Foreman actually accounts his healthy lifestyle to the reason he hasn't succumbed to the symptoms of CTE. And this is the same with Tony. He eats really healthy. He exercises every day. He lives life as if he were training. And like Mr. Foreman, he also prioritizes his sleep, and he lives a healthy, clean life. Tony also takes part in some alternative therapies that he's working on, such as hyperbaric chamber therapy, IV therapy, and he'll be mentioning that in his video. Let me know in the comments down below if you have any experience of this, or if you're going through a similar journey. Share your comments, and don't forget to subscribe. And just to let you know, any money made from today's video will be donated to the Concussion Foundation. That's a great charity helping to raise awareness. Links below if you're interested. In the meantime, if you're worried that you've sustained a concussion playing sports or in boxing, click here where I tell you what you can do about it.